Sombrero, hop, six, seven, and king, king, pa, king, king, pa, and be like an hop, five, six, go back. Hello, welcome to another class, beginner salsa in couples with La Suerte Dance School, Mijo and Ola. We are going to teach you sombrero today. Sombrero is a move that is based in big chunk on Basilala por la mano. So if you haven't watched this video, right now, look in cards, it's just flashing. Watch this video, make sure you know how to do it, and come back to this one and dance with us, sombrero. Let's go. If you've done already Basilala por la mano, learning sombrero will be very, very simple. We start with guapea back, 5, 6, 7, 1, 2, 3, and 5, 6, 7. Steps from girl perspective are exactly the same as Basilala por la mano. So she goes forward, front, front, opposite, inside, outside, outside, and dilekeno hop, and 5, 6, 7. From my point of view, steps are also the same. Step, 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 step. You would say kind of boring, but it is very important that you keep moving your feet and that you keep stomping, even if it's in a spot. She's traveling from my left to my right, like in Basilala por la mano. We are starting from guapea. We are finishing with dilekeno, the same as Basilala por la mano. Meanwhile, she's doing loop to the right, exactly the same, but hands are different. I'm pulling her with my left and instantly swapping to the right. When I pass the right hand, it goes with the thumb to the bottom. So we're like, tsh, palm to palm. I offer second hand on the bottom, and now with two hands up, she's making loop, 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 loop. And we're finishing with the right hand on top of her right shoulder and left on top of my left. Now you could say, aha, we know that from El Uno. And that's not true, because this hand setup is different than in El Uno. Now my hand is lying on top, her hand is on the bottom. This is not natural position. So when we continue with dilekeno, she has to do something to get the hand out. 5, 6, dilekeno, 1, 2, 3, and 5, 6, 7. She's going with her left hand up, but she's starting with her fingers, with her palm. So palm is going up, elbow is staying down, and then she's straightening it up. And then at the end, what Ola finger position do you have? Can you just show it? So middle finger and thumb are getting quite close to each other. The rest of the fingers are spread, but nothing crazy, quite natural position. Like Ola would probably tell you to hold egg. That's what you normally do? Yeah, so hold egg. Think that you are holding an egg with the middle finger and with your thumb. Tense. Yeah, don't tense it. Quite relaxed position, and this hand tilt or bend is outside. Yeah, not just a bit. Okay, I don't know if you can hear her in my microphone. Possibly you can. We'll start from guapea. 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, sombrero, hop and pull, pull, swap, give second, around and around. And dilekeno up, and 5, 6, 7. So now, very quickly, timing for arms. We are pulling before one, she's stepping on one, I'm swapping hand on two, giving second on the bottom on three, and her arm up goes on three as well. 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, sombrero, hop and pull. 1, 2, 3. 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3. And 5, 6, 7. One more time, fluently, sombrero, hop. 1, 2, 3. 5, 6, 7. And 1, 2, 3. And 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3. And 5, 6, 7. We'll do the same from different perspective. 5, 6, 7. And 1, 2, sombrero, hop and pull. 1, 2, 3. And 5, 6, dilekeno, 1, 2, up. And 5, 6, 7, 1, 2, sombrero, hop and pull, girls, front, front, opens. 5, 6, 7, and 1, 2, 3, and 5, 6, 7. Last two things that I have to mention before we go with music. The most important part of this move is the first step where I pull and she goes forward. If she goes back, we have 1, 2. We wasted 2 steps already. We haven't started even the turn. So it is possible to complete it in 4 steps, but it's very, very difficult. So think about that. Another thing, when we finish the move, 5, 6, 7, she's waiting with lifting this hand. She's not doing it before I release it, because we'll show you, yes, during this course, during the beginner's course, sombrero complicado doble, when we will swap hands and we need both. We already done sombrero complicado that bases on the same principle, and it is somewhere in cards. And we'll do also Juana la Cubana, also very similar idea. And then Montaña already, ping, 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 it will be blinking right now in the cards, it's already on our channel. They are all sombrero-based moves. Sombrero is a very important ingredient, very important package when you are learning how to dance Cuban salsa. Many moves are starting with sombrero, or many moves are using sombrero-like actions somewhere halfway through. We'll do everything with music. 5, 6, 7, kinking, 1, 2, 3. 5, 6, 7, and 1, sombrero. Hop, 6, 7, and kinking, pa. King, king, pa, and dile che no hop. 5, 6, go back, back, chicky, chick, and from chicky, poco. One more time, sombrero with all numbers, go. 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, 1, 2, 3, and 5, 6, 7. Short, but not so easy. One, sombrero, hop, and pull. 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, and 1, 2, 3, and 5, 8, and change angle. And 5, 6, 7, go back, cheeky chick, front cheeky pugu, and 1, sombrero. 6, 7, and king king pa, king king pa, and be like an o hop. 5, 6, 7, and 1, 5, 6, 7, and 1 more time, sombrero, hop, and go king king pa, king king pa, and be like an o hop. And 5, 6, 7, and back, chick chick, and front, nice. When we were dancing, another thought came to my mind. Something that is happening in UK, I haven't seen it anywhere outside, but maybe it's only me. So many people try to speed it up and swap hands before they start. So they do toom, 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 and they dance whole guapea, and then from this position continue. No, we don't want that. We want to develop order of movement. We want you to start feeling that you have your arms under control while making steps. You are capable of doing it. If I learn how to dance, everybody can. I always say that to people. Good. Another thing you will start noticing is that many of moves that we are teaching you have some associations in between each other. So now we see that Basilala por la mano and sombrero, in terms of footwork, are very, very similar, technically identical. And more things like that will be happening. You will start noticing more connections between moves. When upper body action will be changing, arms movements will be different, but footwork can be very, very similar or even identical. And you have to get used to it. There are quite many feet actions that are very, very common, and we are using them very often. The next move will follow exactly this idea. We taught you already Kentucky, and the next time we'll show you Enchufla Alarde, that is using exactly the same feet pattern as Kentucky. So we'll see you next time. Before you finish, like, subscribe, and press the bell. Like, subscribe, and press the bell. Follow us on Facebook, follow us on Instagram, and be ready here and watch Kentucky before we post the next video next time. We'll see you there. Bye-bye.